Environmental leaders have an answer for criticism that Ecology Week may be a diversion from more important matters in this country. They say environmental reform transcends and encompasses all other reform movements because it's a sheer battle for world survival.
I'm sure everyone's really aware that the problem exists and that something has to be done, but now we've got to channel our efforts into the right direction and, you know, make sure that something really is done.
And the whole problem in this whole issue is that attitudes won't change that fast, as technology is. And that's the whole problem.
Who should we sort of push this awareness on? Should we push it further on the people who are rapping right now, like today, just constantly talking and talking like they have been for the last 3 or 4 years, especially on the Davis campus? Or should we really go out and propose something that is really feasible? In other words, actually start stopping what's going on.
If this is just a fad, it may be the last fad. It's a matter that requires a sustained long siege against all the causes of pollution. And I'm talking not only of the pollution of war, that's perhaps the gravest threat, the pollution of injustice and poverty in our central cities, the pollution produced by industry, but the pollution produced by the individuals who buy from industry the products that are a part of that pollution. It requires a total commitment by most parts of our society. We probably won't succeed in persuading all parts, but by most parts, to be successful. We have to have the drive and the determination to get laws that will end pollution and control it. And unless we do, we may well be doomed.
In a moment, a report on where California stands in this battle to survive.